know, everyone is familiar with like G, right? You know, 3G, 4G, 5G, 6G, you know, you have a little icon in the corner of your phone and you think the higher number is better. But G is a generation, right? That's all it means. So 3G is an earlier generation than 4G, it's earlier than 5G, and now we're at 6G. What each of these generations effectively means is an increase in data rates, an increase in bandwidth that is available. So 3G was a revolution because it opened up GPS. 4G was video. 5G was Internet of Things and edge computing. And now 6G is about AI, right? So what does that mean? That means that we need 10 to 100 times more data, faster data, in order to be able to utilize the computational power of data centers. Cell phones are radios, right? Radios with screens and computers in them. In the body of your cell phone, there are several antennas that are used to actually radiate the signal that is generated from a series of chips so that you can actually transmit from your cell phone to a cell tower. So radio waves, I mean, historically, you know, the frequencies that we were using were much lower, right? You know, and the waves were much longer. And the advantage of that is that they transmit much further.
Of course, frequencies are going to get higher and higher because the current spectrum that's been allocated by the FCC to 5G communications is actually kind of limited. So it necessitates that people go to something crazy, like above 100 gigahertz or 200 gigahertz or whatever. But with higher bandwidths, what you get is a larger spread between the lowest frequency in a spectrum and the highest frequency in a spectrum. And then it comes back to this age-old problem of having to sync up these low and high frequencies at that exact point in space you want them to send them to and at the right time. So they got to add up in time and space, which means you need a programmable delay between these different frequencies, and that's where our technology plays the most role. So we routed these signals in a 3D fashion, and we caused even more delay on the chip by bouncing them off of various reflectors on the chip itself that we designed with a lot of care. So our hypothesis was that we could extract maximum delay in a signal, that is a time delay in a signal, with as small an area as possible. We were actually quite pleasantly surprised when we actually measured this chip in the lab, and we found that our hypothesis actually worked, in that we had very precise control on the amount of delay we could give to every frequency within a huge spectrum. And we found that, okay, this would definitely support the very large bandwidths that are needed for upcoming 6G and 7G technologies.